Oh, hello, darlings. So nice to see you together. Steve, I don't want to spoil your lunch, but this is rather important. I think I'm going to be arrested. Terribly sorry to embarrass you with all my little problems, Steve, but, well, you've always been so good about legal advice to my charities and my committees.
Clara, I would have been most upset if you hadn't turned to me. Now, what'll you have to drink?
Oh, double brandy straight.
Jean?
No, thanks, Steve. Excuse me, Clara, I'm sure you'd rather speak to Steve alone.
I would prefer you to stay, dear. This does concern you too.
Me?
The halfway house we were going to set up. I'm afraid I've let you down. It'll all have to wait.
All right. Now, you tell us why you think you're going to be arrested.
My company's brought in external auditors. It's a relatively small firm, but highly profitable. I'm the major shareholder. My family left it to me. I was the only one with a head for figures. I'm a qualified accountant, you see. The other investors are friends. Very wealthy, of course. It's really more of a little sideline with them.
And?
Hmm?
Well, you were saying about the external auditors.
Well, I suppose my friends thought it was all getting too much for me, and I was given an assistant. A very bright young man. Too bright, in fact. It's a pity. Well, when he discovered a few discrepancies in my books, he suggested we call in the external auditors. Well, I am a director, I know, but what could I do? I had to agree. I was outnumbered.
Doesn't every company have external auditors?
Oh, mostly public companies, dear. The shareholders had a vote some years ago and let me handle the books. Now, this had to happen.
Just how much money is involved, Claire?
Oh, Steve, I don't know.
Well, I'm sure if it's only a question of a few mistakes, a little bad accountancy.
Bad accountancy? It was brilliant. Well, not quite brilliant. I am being found out.
Do you mean to tell me that you've been deliberately fiddling the books?
Well, yes, I suppose I have. I can't deny it.
But why?
I needed the money.
You need the money?
Of course. Good heavens. You don't imagine I kept it to myself. All that money that I have been donating to my charities over the years, where do you think it came from? I couldn't possibly have afforded it out of my own purse.
God, they feed you earlier in here than they did in the last place I was in.
Just as long as you eat it, Mrs. Smith.
Well, I haven't been waited on since I was at the Monarch Hotel. Oh, boy, was that a day.
Special occasion?
My husband thought so.
Oh, second honeymoon.
No, I shot him.
I brought you those magazines you asked for.
Oh, thanks, you are a doll.
Just a minute.
God, I don't know what the heck she thinks you're smuggling in.
Just checking to see that the centrefold's still there.
Oh, God. Now I know what they mean by splitting your side laughing.
I'll be back to give you your sponge later.
Here, why aren't you sending that young doctor that's been prodding at me?
Sorry. They haven't been giving sponges since Florence Nightingale. Good morning, Miss Bennett.
Well, Vera. Couldn't keep away from me, eh?
Obviously, you're feeling better, Smith.
What? I feel like I've been stabbed in the guts.
They say you're doing very nicely.
Yeah, well, they sew you up real well in here.
There's no reason why you can't return to Wentworth soon.
Give us a go, Vera. I could do with another week in here. You don't want me stitches coming undone, do you?
You'll be transferred the day after tomorrow.
Please, not when I'm eating.
Where'd this come from?
Oh, I reckon they think I'm a charity case. Well, you know, if some of them get too many or they pop off, they give the leftovers to the needy.
Well, I'll be back to see you get to Wentworth in one piece.
Yeah. You do that.
Could I have a word with you?
I was so sorry to hear of your injury. I thought the cyclamen would brighten up your room. If you have a minute to write, I'd love to hear from you.
Which old trut.
And talk about a hypocritical sham. Saying that she was giving the money to charity? I bet. She'd probably get most of it for herself. And it's not as though she even needs the money. It's just pure, unadulterated greed.
Why are you so upset, then?
I have to tell Karen that the halfway house isn't a go.
What's that got to do with Karen?
I mentioned it to her. Once she was released, she was going to run the place.
Jean, you can't go round building up these girls' hopes when there's the slightest possibility that things could go wrong. I mean, it just makes my job that much harder.
Oh, come off it, Meg.
Oh, let's just drop it. I'm not in the mood. I just want to go home.
The girls are never going to believe it when I tell them I was tucked in by a cop.
Oh, we're almost human. Oh. The nurse is on her way.
Ooh. I'm going to be glad to get back to my own bed. At least I won't be watched over 24 hours.
Sorry, regulations.
Yeah.
Do you get on well with the other women?
I run them. They're almost human too.
Even the one who stabbed you?
She was next screw. They're different. Oh.
You'll get a good night's sleep after you take this. Oh, you're not uncomfortable, are you?
Oh. She'll be right.
The tea trolley's waiting outside.
Thanks.
Anderson out.
Oh, I don't feel so good, Miss Bennett.
What's the matter? Well, then report to sick call. Come on, Lizzie, hurry up.
He's still feeling sick, Miss Bennett. She should get sick more often.
Yeah. Hey, maybe it's catching. I mean, she'd be nasty enough to do that.
I just feel crook, that's all.
Well...
Oh, I don't know. I wish Bea was here.
Well, I don't. It's her fault I lost all my privileges.
Yeah, well, I reckon she's better than Monty.
You got her or that Burke woman, and she's a desperate woman.
Yeah. She scares me, you know, Lizzie.
Oh, g'day, 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 g'day.
Oh, morning, Monty.
Hey, how about you two giving us a hand to put that Burke bitch in her place?
What you got in mind, Monty?
Doreen?
Can't you forget it?
Forget? Ah, oh, get a load of you. Listen, if I let her get away having me stuck in solitary, she'll think she's got me over a barrel.
Yeah, well, Bea would try and keep us out of trouble.
You don't reckon I'm as good as Bea, Doreen?
You'll be Smith's roommate, aren't you?
That's right.
Guess you two were pretty buddy-buddy.
Try to get along with people.
So you'd go along with Bea giving Ferguson the run of the place?
I'm not on anyone's side if that's what you're trying to get at.
Yeah, that's what I heard about you. Miss Goody Two-Shoes. Think you're above people. That's okay. Just keep that pretty little nose clean. I won't have to break it for you.
Karen Travis? Miss Vernon wants to see you. I haven't finished with you yet. Now, you've already caused enough trouble by accusing Ferguson of being responsible for Anne Yates' death. That sort of behaviour ends here and now.
Whatever you reckon's a fair thing.
Anderson, Bert's with you. Can come back later.
Oh, send Lizzie away and you won't get her back for a week.
Yeah, we've got to have a shower before breakfast, miss.
Oh, all right then, but don't take all day.
Hello, Nolene.
What do you want?
Nothing. I was just wondering how you was going. I reckon that was a real funny joke you played on Monica.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Doreen obviously doesn't know which side her bread's buttered on.
Yeah, gone mouldy.
She's got more up top than you stupid cows.
Just cut it out. Get a move on.